I am Pankaj Agarwal. I'm the founder and CEO at TagHive. It's an education technology company based in South Korea, and we have an office in India as well. What we do is we are on a mission to make learning and teaching more effective. By effective, I mean more efficient, make it more cheap, affordable, make it easy for students and teachers to use the technology and improve their performance. So in our company so far, we have two brands that we manage. One is Class Sathi and one is Class Key. So these two products or these two brands are about making classrooms smart by using a clicker solution and also enable students to study at home by themselves through our at-home learning app called Class Sathi. So we have multiple business models. As a startup, we of course want to try out different models and see what works the best and which has the most traction. So right now we have B2C model where we provide our at-home learning app to students directly. And then we have B2B model where we work with technology providers in global markets to provide our classroom solutions to the schools. For example, in Korea, we are working with a education technology provider to schools, and they are providing our products to schools. Likewise, we are trying to work with technology providers in India, big technology providers that have access to schools so that they can provide our clicker solution to schools. And we're also having B2G model where we work with the governments, especially in India, because India is a huge market. There's a million plus schools, government schools, that need a lot of technology upgrade at a low cost. So we work with the government directly to provide our classroom technology solutions to the schools through the government. So we're trying different models, B2C, B2B, B2G. And all of these incidentally seem to be working out great. So we hope to continue with them for some time. And if need be, we will allocate more resources to one or two models depending on how they go. But right now, all three are really on fire and looking forward to see the magic happen going forward. So as a startup, you try out different models. You know, there's a lot of iteration that happens. So, you know, of course, you start with the free model first, then you add premium features to that. You start with, you know, talking to partners, talking to other, companies, seeing the competition, and then you decide on a model. So likewise, we kind of navigated around and saw the market, saw the customers' reactions to different products, and the pricing of other products. So, you know, all those led us to come up with our own model. And in fact, we are doing a lot of innovation in the business model part as well, part of which I cannot share right now. But idea is to really create something nice as a product and also create a nice business model where the consumers really feel that they're getting a lot of value from the product, right? At the end, it's about creating value for the consumer. And that is where we are completely focusing on and making sure that we don't, you know, end up charging them a lot and providing them less. So, you know, a lot of things are happening in that front. And, you know, as I said before, we're looking at all the models, B2B, B2C, B2G, and all of these hopefully, you know, will give us insights to really improve our offering to the end user, to the end customer. And we're looking forward to that. It keeps on evolving actually based on the inputs. With the Corona happening, with the COVID happening, you know, again, we have to change our way of thinking. We have to see how we can be more effective at home, because earlier our model was about making the classroom learning and teaching more effective, but that is not possible now. So we're trying to evolve our product to really see how we can help schools, teachers, and children in this tough environment and make sure that the learning continues and they don't find this expensive, they find it valuable, and all of that. So working towards that. And I think huge potential, you know, there's a lot of potential that is there in this market, in the education segment in general, and of course in India in particular because of the huge market size that India offers. So, you know, willing to really work with partners, looking to forge partnerships with companies, foundations, governments, individuals. And we're also, in fact, hiring a lot of people, you know, looking for new hires in different markets. So, you know, all of that is really exciting times for us and looking forward to really grow the business globally. So Pangyo is a startup valley of Korea. You know, the environment, the energy that you see here is very different. If you do a business in Korea as a startup, I think you got to be in Pangyo, because of course there are a lot of other startups as well around you, so it makes it easy for you. You can randomly meet a person and say, hey, are you working on this product? I'm working on this product. Why don't we collaborate? Or we can just talk and share our experiences on different challenges, for example, hiring challenges or some systemic issues. So because we are at the same level in terms of business, it becomes much easier to share, connect, share our challenges, discuss, get ideas, and then, you know, perhaps collaborate as well. So that is the big plus of Pangyo. And also for getting talent, you know, when we hire a new talent, these days, by the way, I've seen that a lot of talent wants to come to startups. So if you are in Pangyo, which is recognized as the startup valley of Korea, it makes it much easier for us to convince the talent to join us. So in terms of talent, in terms of energy, in terms of you know, the culture, I think Pangyo really helps us set the tone and focus on the business more. So really happy. You know, if you are in Seoul or any other place, which is again good, but I think you have too much of distraction. But Pangyo is more about startup. Let's make it happen. You know, you read all these inspiring quotes all here and there. That somehow gives you energy. So, you know, a lot of plus points, I think, that we have seen. And again, the facilities that government has made here for startups is amazing. You know, you don't have to worry about a particular sort of infrastructure, meeting rooms, you know, they are there. If you want to borrow some handsets for testing purposes, you can borrow anytime. If you want to, you know, go and attend some seminars, there are a bunch of them happening. You know, I mean, a lot of activities happen in this region, in this Pangyo area. And depending on the startup's needs, depending on what they want to take advantage of, we can choose. It's like a buffet, you know, I'll choose this. And that makes it very easy for us. So, you know, that is why I think I like Pangyo, and definitely it helps a lot to be in the right sort of mindset to grow the business.